Why would you watch people play a game instead of playing it yourself? It doesn't make any sense. If you're a sports fan, you've likely heard that criticism from someone in your life at one point or another. On its face, it isn't an outright terrible question. After all, playing a sport in many ways is a more efficient use of one's time, at least in a practical sense. Sports are fantastic exercise, almost always mentally stimulating, and not to mention great for socializing.
Guys, where do ye go around here anyway for a good bread dinner?
Back to fucking Newfoundland.
Oh, now don't go mentioning home, now gives me the warm tinglies and I'll dash.
But as many who live and breathe the sports life can attest, simply playing doesn't scratch the same itch that viewing does. If anything, it only makes that urge greater. Why is that? My initial thought was the obvious one, it's the quality of play. Lord knows Mario Lemieux isn't stepping onto a frozen Lake Ramsey to play some shimmy on a Sudbury Saturday night. I mean, let's face it, chances are you're not going to be exactly blown away by whatever your buddy Jimmy from accounting does on the ice. But why do we care what someone does with a puck or a ball anyway? Well, the answer to that, I think, goes beyond sports. Although we are a fickle and diverse species, almost all people seem to value this one quality humanity possesses over others. Competence. If you look at biology, you can understand why that is the case. In a head-to-head battle, even the strongest man alive is no match for the might of a silverback gorilla or a Siberian tiger. Yet thanks to our ability to manipulate and innovate tools, even the smallest amongst us is capable of taking down such beasts. Competence is humanity's great equalizer. Given that, it is only natural we would have an inclination towards seeking it out, both in ourselves and in others. Literature and legend highlight our desire for competence well, be it Hercules or King Arthur or even Harry Potter. People throughout every era of recorded history have been drawn to the stories of those who rose to the top, those who strove for a goal, struggled, and overcame. Professional sports encompasses all of that. The Miracle on Ice wasn't a hockey game, it was a modern retelling of David and Goliath, the underdog overcoming a giant through a combination of adaptability and sheer force of will.
5 seconds left in the game, do you believe in miracles? Yes!
Unbelievable!
Kobe Bryant's win-at-all-costs attitude and his subsequent success is not unlike other great historical figures like Julius Caesar or Sun Tzu. Every clutch and fadeaway jumper, every walk-off homer, every overtime winner is yet another chapter entered into our modern-day mythos.
Sidney Crosby, the golden goal, and Canada has once in a lifetime Olympic gold.
And that is why we watch.